Since we started the On Two Wheels and Four Paws video series about traveling on BMW adventure motorcycles with our German Shepherd Moxie, we've received a lot of questions about how we outfitted our motorbikes. In this video, Greg will go through the accessories and mods that he's made to his F700GS, and I'll share a bit about my G650 in a separate video.
First up, this Altrider skid plate is bombproof, looks great, and provides a lot of coverage. It also costs a whopping $400. I love it and I wouldn't exchange it, but I'm glad it's only a one-time purchase. These crash bars are also from Altrider, and they're also brutally expensive at $385. That said, I would absolutely buy them again if I had to. At the very end of our North and South America trip a few years back, I hit a gravel-strewn turn at high speed and flipped my bike. The crash bars performed beautifully, and the only damage to the bike was cosmetic. Sticking with a theme, this headlight guard is also from Altrider. I prefer the clear plastic rather than the metal grating type. It comes with a glare guard, so there's absolutely no problem riding with it on day or night. Lastly from Altrider is my favorite and most useful accessory, the dual control brake system. It comes in at $85, but it's so essential for off-road riding that it really should come standard from the factory. The bottom plate makes the rear brakes more comfortable while sitting, and the elevated platform is much easier to reach while standing. From Touratech comes another small but essential accessory, the large Sidestand foot. There's simply no putting your kickstand down on wet, muddy, or sandy ground without it. And again, it should have come standard from the factory. Also from Touratech, the Explore HP rear shock. The OEM shock turned to jelly after about 40,000 kilometers, and this replacement, which is made to your individual specs, has performed beautifully. Unlike its big sister, the F800GS, the F700 doesn't have inverted front forks, which leaves the stanchions exposed to rocks and debris. These neoprene socks from Touratech work perfectly, but I couldn't find them on the website, so they might no longer be available. Last but not least from Touratech, these are the Zega Pro panniers. The aluminum boxes are surprisingly crash resistant and fairly easy to hammer back into shape. Because luggage space is precious and the lid is usually hard to fill, I drilled small holes and screwed hangers in to hold cargo nets on either side. Actually, there are two layers of nets, but really that's overkill. The steel rack has held up through many, many crashes. There's a connection point under the seat that seems to be a weak link and tends to crack, but it's easy enough to repair with a little welding. The handguards are from BMW, and I'm very satisfied with them. The luggage rack is also from BMW, and counterintuitively, I prefer that it's small. This is the touring windscreen, also from BMW. I went through many, many windscreens looking for just the right one. I love it for off-road and moderate speeds because it's nowhere near my field of view, and in my opinion, nothing even comes close in terms of aesthetics. That said, it's pretty rubbish at high speed. Fortunately, here in Central America, high speed is pretty scarce, but when we lived back home in the States, or when we take a paid highway in Mexico, I use this wind deflector from Wunderlich. Just be aware that to use this F800 touring windscreen with the F700, you need an adapter kit. These 2-inch pivot risers from ROX are excellent because not only do they increase the height of the handlebars, they also let you bring them closer or further away. Closer in my case. Secured to the handlebar is this fantastic RAM Mounts Universal Cell Phone Holder Kit. The X grip is excellent, and although I never worry about my phone shaking loose, it comes with an elastic rubber tether just in case. Finally, two accessories of my own creation. First is the mount for this aluminum tool tube from Moto Arbo in the UK. The tool tube is fantastic and totally rain and water crossing proof. How and where to mount it is the problem. At first I mounted it to the pannier rack, but that's a lot of strain when the pannier is also full. So I came up with this mount that secures to the chassis at the mounting points intended for the BMW Vario Cases rack. The second homemade mod is this radiator guard, which I made from a stylish perforated aluminum sheet, an iron frame, and some rivets.
Okay, so that's about as concise as Greg has ever been when talking about his motorbike, and it took a lot of takes and a lot of cajoling to keep him from going on longer. Anyway, we hope you found this interesting or useful. I'll tell you a bit about the accessories on my G650GS in a separate video. And of course, be sure to subscribe so you'll be notified when each new episode of On Two Wheels and Four Paws is released.